love you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Can you jam those beautiful hands again to the King of Kings? To the Lord of Lords, you are who has made it possible for you and I to be alive, to witness this awesome day. Hallelujah. 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 Now, do you know why you need to congratulate that person? Today's date is what? 7/7. Is it not so? And 7 stands for what? Perfection. Now, if you are familiar with your scripture very, very well, you will know that I'm going to, you know, declare some words to us, and I'm going to start that with Matthew 7:7. And the scripture says there, ask. I can hear you. Ask. Seek. And knock. Now that is why you are telling somebody congratulations, because you are already in the atmosphere of miracle. Now that is the word, password, 7th edition. So as we, you know, take one or two songs to, you know, appreciate God for the gift of life, you know, for making you to, you know, be part of those that will witness this 7th edition. You know, this program started 7 years ago and we are having the 7th edition, and I know already that God is out to settle somebody's case in the name of Jesus. If you are not going to tell yourself, I am that person. And of course, you know that the background to this password for this year is gotten from no other scripture but from the scripture according to Joshua 6, where God instructed the children of Israel to do what? To go around the city, the walls of Jericho 7 times, right? Sounding it. Before that 7th day, they had to go round once each day for 6 days. But that 7th day, they went round 7. And at the sound of that trumpet, the walls did what? It was brought clean. And that is what God, what Jesus, he said to do in somebody's life that is here tonight. I don't know who that person is, but if you're that person, you can hit your chest and say, I am that person. Alright, join me as we worship God before I make some prophetic declarations to us. On to go down. Okay.
can we sing a song? Oh, my mother's people.
Thank you.
your books.
Everything that has been disjointed shall be brought back. And he said there will be restoration. And by the reason of that anointing over my head, and by the prophecy I am carrying now, of which you are under my voice, by the reason of the power of God and the call of God upon my head, I release upon your life, books will come back to books. Every of your values shall be lifted. Shaking in your life, and you will come and happy for this generation. The Lord will move you forward, and I declare last day to your life, every barren situation in your life, I declare in the land of your life, receive fruitfulness in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. Can you lay that 2 hands together upon your head and say, oh, Luame, Loya, Yellow, Aha, oh, Missare, Aya, oh, Luame, Aya, Loya, Yellow, oh.
Jesus, I'm very simple song. It sings every song in heaven. Shine glad you're growing. Every day, Shabbat, acts come from. You know the song? In the name of Jesus Christ. So when you are at any junction where seven is mentioned, you must know that there is something spiritual, supernatural, significant about it. The second one is the common one when I was going, and I know for many of us that's the same thing, is the story of the wall of Jericho. Seven was mentioned, was associated with this story. Seven trumpets, 7 days, 7 times, and the shouting came after. Seven, seven, seven. This is another episode that showed us that there is something spiritual, there is something particular about seven. So you might have been playing, you might have been doing so many things, but when you come to a point where seven is mentioned, know that God has something to do with that time. Not only God, the devil is interested in such time. You can provoke the devil into action, and you can provoke God into action by the number seven. And all of us know that when God created heaven and earth, the Bible says on the seventh day, he rested. Praise the Lord. What am I trying to tell us? That seven is significant. So our gathering here at this password 7.0 must be significant in your life. I know this is the time when we speak the word of God. Some people will start looking at their phone. Some will start sleeping. That's the nature of it. But I know that someone that knows that this seventh month of the year is for his blessing. Such person will be able to hold on to tonight and say, I will not leave this place until my blessing is full. And that person is you, in the name of Jesus Christ. I said that person is you, in the name of Jesus Christ. So I want to read Joshua chapter 6, verses 15, 16, and 20. And it came to pass on the seventh day that they rose early from the dawning of the day and compassed the city after the same manner 7 times. Only on that day they compassed the city 7 times. See, 7 times. And it came to pass at the 7th time, when the priest blew the trumpets, Joshua said unto the people, shout, for the Lord hath given you the city. So the people shouted. Praise the Lord. Don't worry, you shout, you're shouting. You will still shout. Oh, you want to shout now? Oh, yeah, shout! And when they shouted, Joshua said unto people, shout, for the Lord hath given you the city. So the people shouted when the priest blew the trumpet. And it came to pass, when they heard the sound of the trumpet, the people shouted with great shout, and the wall fell down flat. So that the people went up into the city, every man straight before him, and they took the city. They shouted after the 7777 episode. And the wall of Jericho fell flat. We've had so many descriptions of the wall of Jericho. Some people say it's when you can park cars on the fence on the wall of Jericho. When I looked up on the internet for the wall of Jericho, I discovered that it was more than a wall. It was a city on its own that they call a wall. Because you have a fence that is as large as from that place to this place. In between are blocks built. So I was imagining how did it fall flat? Because it's a whole building on its own. But I don't want to go to that place. I want to concentrate this few minutes I have on you and I. What are the walls of Jericho in our lives? How do I identify the things that looks like the wall of Jericho? When I'm shouting, when I'm praying, when I'm dancing, what are the things that I want this power of God that worked for the Israelites at the wall of Jericho to pull down in my life? What are the things I'm expecting that will fall in my life after this meeting? And quickly, I'll have to do that because of my time. Number one is that the wall of Jericho is whatever stands between you and your promised land. When God was bringing them out of Egypt, He told them, I'm taking you to a promised land. God did not mention the land, but God knew where He was taking them to. They do not have a name for where they were going to, but they knew that God was taking them somewhere. They do not have a picture, exact picture of how the place looks like, but they are sure they have this desire that we are leaving Egypt and we are going to a promised land. A picture of how the future will look like. Oh, when I'm married. Oh, when I get a job. Oh, when I do this. When I'm promoted. I pray your vision, your purpose, your desired future will come to pass in the name of Jesus Christ. But unfortunately, when they got to Jericho, it seems as if the dream has come to an end. Because they met with a wall that seemed to them to be impenetrable. They got to a wall that seems impossible for them to surmount. So they were thinking, how are we going to get to the promised land? How are we going to move forward from here? And at that point, God intervened and God gave them an instrument. And the instrument associated with the 777 was to shout, praise the Lord. So what is that thing that is standing between you and your envisioned future? What is that thing that is standing between you and your fulfillment in life? What is that thing that is standing between you and the actualization of your dreams? What is that thing that is standing between you and your future marriage? What is that thing that is standing between you and giving back to children? What is that thing that is standing between you and your admission? What is that thing that is standing between you? And when the man was saying, we want to travel, tell somebody you are traveling. I said, be careful of what you are saying so that you don't land in Congo. Praise the Lord. So say where you are traveling to so you don't land in your village. Praise the Lord. So when you have a definite picture, or you have a vision, a dream of what you want to become. But when you get to a point in your life, it seems very difficult for you to move on. That point in your life is a wall of Jericho. I'm not ashamed to say things now. Of my mother. And the last born of my mother happens to be the fifth born. So you know the distance. The year I was graduating, my first degree graduation was my fifth born, my junior sister, master's graduation. Can you measure the length? Do you get what I say? The fifth born, my junior sister, that is the fifth to me. When I was graduating, my first degree graduation was the same graduation with my fifth born. When she was doing her master's graduation, I was doing my first degree. Not I didn't want to go to school. I was sitting for exams. I was doing so many things. I was sitting. I was doing this. I was going through pre and going through post. And I just discovered that something will disturb this year. Next year is something else that will disturb. Upper year is something else that will disturb. And I prayed and I fasted and I cried until my wall of Jericho fell. Someone is here. You have been going for marriages. You have been testing. You have been going to listen to testimonies of others. Because there is a wall of Jericho, you are still outside the zone of celebration. Today, your wall of Jericho will fall in the name of Jesus Christ. You are supposed to have been promoted. You are supposed to have married. When other people go to airport, when they go to embassy, when they get their way through easily. But when it comes to your home, it becomes so difficult. That wall of Jericho is coming down in the name of Jesus Christ. The wall of Jericho is a barrier to your access. It's a barrier to entering into God's purpose for your life. It's something that stands before you anytime you want to move forward. I want to tell you, some of us think, oh, I'm good, I'm married, I'm this and that. But you know that where you are is the least of someone else. That means you can still be better than where you are. Where you are, where the best that you are holding on to is the least for someone else. That means there is still a space up there. And when you try to move, you discover something breaks you down. That word of Jericho, we give way in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. 1, 2, 3. Shout! Shout out to the Lord! Shout out to the Lord! Shout out to the Lord! Sickness is leaving your body. Shout out to the Lord! The yoke is broken. Shout out to the Lord! That covenant is broken. Shout out to the Lord! Your miracle is coming. Shout out to the Lord! Your fetters are broken. Shout, shout, shout! Shout! Your husband is coming for you. Your wife is coming for you. You are healed. Keep shouting, keep shouting.
Shout, 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 shout. Hallelujah.
Let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness, perfecting holiness in the fear of God. God is calling you and I that as we shout before Him tonight, this morning, as we shout before Him in this program, shout with faith, shout in holiness, shout with the confidence that this God will do it. Not that you shout only, you shout with expectation. If you are willing and obedient, willingness is a matter of expectation. Willingness is a matter of anticipation. The more expectant you are, the more desperate and focused you will be. When Elijah told him that if you want to receive this anointing, you have to look at me. You have to be expectant. You have to be expecting. And this man was following him and was focused and was expectant. At the point when the wind took it away, he was looking at him and he got it. So Joshua said, when I shout, when we shout, shout, and they shouted, and the wall fell. And immediately all of them entered and began to take what belongs to them and began to destroy the things they need to destroy. As we shout tonight, as we pray tonight, as we sing tonight, I want you to know, be expectant. You can't shout tonight and go back home and start sleeping. You can't shout tonight and go back home and tap behind you. When you go back, go and write that application again. When you go back, go and do the examination again. When you go back, don't go and try that person, oh, my life is for sale. Go out there because someone is looking for you. Because someone is going to touch your life for good. Because you're going to have an encounter with someone that will bring your life from that experience you do not desire. What am I telling you tonight? That as we cry to the Lord with the covenant of the supernatural 777, I want you to believe that as you see the rest of this program, God is going to come into your life. Your walls will fall. Your walls will fall. God will give you access. God will give you access. Men will be brought to you to bless you. Men will be brought to you to support you. Men will be brought to you to lift you up. Your helpers will locate you. A land that is built within a wall, that is inside the wall. Such a life become invisible. Such a life become unavailable. I pray that as from now, your life will be available for miracle. Your life will be available for blessing. Your life will be available for men to help you. Can you please rise on your feet as we pray? Can you please rise on your feet as we pray? I said, Lord, let my walls fall. You want to shout, but just say that to God. Every wall built around my life, every wall built against my life, every wall that has kept me away from blessing, let them begin to fall. Every wall of sin, every wall of the devil, every wall of evil covenant, every wall of demonic atmosphere, Lord, let them fall in the name of Jesus. We are going to shout. I'll say 1, 2, 3, and you will shout. And as you are shouting, shout with faith.
Thank you. Yeah!
as the bloody alarm, you make a shout. Don't stand where you are standing. Move. Jericho has crumbled already. The Jericho of delay is down already. The Jericho of retrogression is down already. The Jericho of failure is down already. The first onslaught, make the noise.
Shut up. Even before I Oh, reaching for spiritual influence and using the stage in the ring. See, this girl is not a fake hearted. This girl is not a black hearted. The love drawn and the corn hearted. How dare you cry out to God to come and bargain and blaspheme for belonging? See, I call this bluff. Because counterfeit copyrights is co-opting, branding gospel music for cameras. Where are the real choristers? See, the writers, the worshippers, the Levites, where are they? What happened to the lineage of Aaron, the preachers, the teachers? See, we are saved by the standard of belonging. Belonging to the Spirit who holds us. You see, every man without faith, without the Spirit of God, still holds the faith. I see, I've been looking for the worshipper who doesn't care about followers, who put the gospel before the price tag, who surrenders as vessels of God to shake the room. What are we thanking God and praising God for? We're not bridging what was now and everything beyond. The gospel is not something to play with. It's not something to mock or compromise. Not something to blaspheme or call it faith. When this gospel is the main reason, distraction. Sorry, let's come here. Reason some of us still breathe. It's the fountain we seek from. It's how we heal from our hurts and anxieties and frustrations. This gospel is the only thing we've got. How we turn our horrors to hallelujah. This is how heaven keeps our hands in us. Where we praise Him. How the Spirit guides and handles us. If I may be honest, it's hard to find us a new age crowd of worshippers who wants to just praise Him. It's really hard. See, this gospel is not a virus. It really helped finding a salvation pain infected right at this date. You see, and that is why from my delivery room to this day, from the incubator to this stage, I've been fighting for my life to praise His name. So if anyone calls me an amateur in God's lineage, I'll tell them my greatest evidence of world war, I've won by His actions in God. You see, my anxiety is going to be pressure into passion for His God into my skin. You see, I serve a God who uses a broom to open the door to His grace to keep. You see, I write the truth to imagine. Because His words is true and everything else is fiction. You see, I'm a full-faced Holy Ghost writer. I write a release like a soldier ready to dawn to counter. You see, like a hunter, my aim is precise to aim. Like a hunter, my aim is precise to aim. You see, the enemy, you see, you can tell the enemy, my energy from my being is like a cannonball. I don't have to wait to be a gunner to fire. You see, the angels around me are dancing with white apparels, united. I see, I serve a loving God and I'll never walk alone. That is why I need Jesus like my Lord. His air, I need His gracious grace, I need His rest. You see, I need the sovereignty of the Father, the authenticity of the Son, and the gentleness of the Spirit. He says, I am that I am. But believe in me is who He is. He's Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. Now tell me, how do you describe a God who exists in the heavens, on earth, in us, and still exists in Himself? How do I define a God who starts in Himself and ends in Himself? We say we are timeless, but He exists before time, in time, beyond time, in between time, and yet.
Jesus is
Oh, God. Okay.
Jesus, and the peace of God which passes all understanding